all time to go along with the best defense in the league, you should be 8-0. So why do we question if the Pats are legit? Maybe because of what some would call their cupcake schedule thus far. But their next five opponents are all 500 or above. So, CeCe, what will we learn about the Patriots in the next 6 weeks? I'm sure Nick could rattle off who they have.
Oh, yeah. Baltimore, Philly, Dallas, Houston, Kansas City is their next five games.
I think that what we're going to learn is it's going to bring credibility to New England is the best team in the league. Starting the season, we didn't know with Gronk and some other things what this team would be like, but we thought that they were going to be one of the four best teams regardless of what they were going to do. The defense, we thought, was going to be a very good defense. We thought the secondary was going to be the best secondary in the NFL, but they are not going to be gifted short fields, turnovers, touchdown, where the offense can play media coaches, competent coordinators, competent quarterbacks that they're going to be playing against. Now, I've played against the legendary 85 Bears after they were just coming out of it. All right, 85, 86. I came into the league in 87. All right, they beat us in the playoffs in 88, but we played them in the regular season. I played against Baltimore, 2000 Baltimore. I played against the New York Football Giants with Lawrence Taylor. So I played against some of the greatest defenses that we've ever seen. I don't think this is one. And the reason why is they don't have one guy within their front seven that would draw a double team or bring fear. Now, when you put the scheme, the combination coverages, the way they come at you with a variety of blitzes, that makes this defense, yes, it could be a special defense. But I think that we're going to see over this course of the schedule, no, this is not a legendary defense. And you can run on this defense. You just have to stay in the game. Be patient. Don't turn the ball over. Play a short a game like they want to play. Make this game short. We'll run it. Get into third and short. Try to convert. If we won't, we'll punt. Because that offense with New England, it's not going to be able to run out of your sights. And I believe teams in this next five-game window, they will press them.
The reason I'm so excited for these next five games is because what Cris said is 100% true, that when you talk about the greatest defenses of all time, there are specific names that come to mind, and they are some of the greatest players of all time. You said 2000 Baltimore. Well, Ray Lewis and friends. 02 Bucks, Warren Sapp, Derek Brooks, and friends. Pick the Giants team you want. Lawrence Taylor, by the way, with Bill Belichick involved there. The 85 Bears, Mike Singletary, and a bunch of guys.
Isn't that what makes a defense so great, to be able to be that good without having a guy who requires a double team?
Well, but that's what's so confusing about this Patriots defense, because personnel wise they absolutely don't match up to any of those teams. Production wise they are, through eight games, the most effective defense the league has seen since the merger. The defense is allowing less than 7 points per game. We are halfway through the year. None of those defenses were able to do that through this portion of the season. How much of that is the fact that the best quarterback they have faced was Ben Roethlisberger in week one, who might have already been dealing with an elbow issue? The second best quarterback they have faced is Baker Mayfield, and he has struggled all year long. And the third best quarterback, God, I don't know. I mean, it's not Luke Falk, I know that. Is it Sam Darnold? I'm not certain. But so now we get to see him not only against five good defenses, well, four good defenses in the Chiefs, but five really good quarterbacks, four of whom, or maybe you could argue all five of whom, add an element of what they can do with their legs. Lamar is one of the greatest running quarterbacks ever. Carson can run a bit. Dak, we know, can run. Deshaun, we know, can run. Patrick Mahomes, we know, can run.
Wow. So it's quite a list.
This is where we all had the Patriots in the AFC Championship game. You two had them in the Super Bowl, if not winning it. We all had them as the one seed. Whether or not this Patriots team is going to be a team that has a gaudy regular season record but can be had in the postseason, we will get some information on over these next 6 weeks, because we'll get an idea of what they look like against the types of teams you'll play in the postseason. And Cris's concern about, can the offense consistently go 75 yards, to me is a totally legitimate one, and one the offense has not had to answer. And as bad as the quarterbacks they have faced have been, the opposing defenses they have faced have been almost nearly as bad, except for that Buffalo game, which was the one time they were tested this season.
So that's my question. The defense has more than done its part, regardless of what you think of the opposition. position. How does this offense get any better? This is the offense now, basically, moving forward.
Yeah.
How are they going to get better suddenly over the course of the next,
this next
five-game stretch?
Develop an identity. Know what you can and what you can't do, and that's what typically what they do. And right now, they can't develop an identity because they don't have the personnel. They have two tight ends 1 week. Now they don't have any tight ends. They bring back Ben Watson. Mm-hmm. Wide receivers. Edelman's in and out of the lineup. You know, Dorsett's been in and out of the lineup. Josh Gordon in and out of the lineup. Now they trade for Sanu. So they need a couple games where they can develop some continuity. Sony Michel, he hadn't been the same. Left tackle rotation. They're on their second center. Right guard. Like, they have so many different combinations going on. But the one thing, as far as from a historic perspective, every defense that you mentioned, if they had faced the same teams, same quarterbacks, they would have at least those numbers. I believe them to be better. But as far as the question about New England's offense, if you talk about all the legendary defenses, all of them had the same question too. Chicago Bears, was their offense and Jim McMahon, were they going to be good enough? Trent Dilfer with the Tampa Bay, you know, are they going to be good enough
there? The Ravens with that defense.
Of course. So all of the legendary defense, that is one thing they do have in common. I don't think they're in the same breath as those other defenses that went on to win Super Bowls. So, but we'll see the rest of the schedule.
In Belichick's 20-year tenure, through eight games, the two most dominant units, according to the advanced stats, were the 07 offense and this year's defense. The 07 offense made sense. You had Brady at his prime. They added Moss. They had Welker. You had all these reasons why it's like, oh, okay, we know why they're that. This team, maybe the best player on the defense, is making $900,000 this year. And they traded him away 3 years ago in Jamie Collins. Certainly the best front seven guy they've had. Stephon Gilmore, maybe the best player on the defense.
Yes.
So it just doesn't make sense from what they are doing to who is actually doing.
That's why you know it's the schedule and who they've played against. That's what makes it make sense. That's how they're able to get that done.
All right, let's take a break. Coming up, will the Cleveland Browns preseason hype prove too much for them to overcome? Still ahead on First Things First.
Tell them you told me so.
I told you.